So it's my privilege today to be able to introduce a good friend of mine, a former colleague, and professor emeritus of Boston University and president of Bode Associates, Professor Zvi Bode. Thank you for being here, Zvi.
My pleasure, Austin.
So in today's session, we're going to review, first of all, what is life cycle finance theory, so we can all get a tutorial on that, and then how you can use it in financial planning, not only for defined contribution plans, but also really for retirement income planning. So we have a packed agenda. Now we get to go back to school and learn about life cycle finance. Professor Bode, the floor is yours. And maybe before I get you going, I wanted to ask you, where does life cycle finance even come from?
All right, I'm glad you started with that question, Austin, because it gives me the opportunity to say something about the history of the subject matter of the life cycle in the economics literature. And there is a voluminous literature in economics. Several Nobel Prizes have been given for work on the theory of life cycle consumption. Most notably, Franco Modigliani, Milton Friedman, and that theory is central to all of economics, because economics is really about a theory of how society runs with consumer sovereignty. Okay, consumers are at the center of economic theory. The original work, which is still considered the classical theory of consumption over time, the allocation of economic resources over time, is Irving Fisher's work from the early 20th century, The Theory of Interest. In other words, how you can explain interest rates, equilibrium interest rates, on the basis of consumer decisions whether to consume today or tomorrow. Okay, they call it the rate of time preference, technical idea. Anyhow, suffice it to say that all of that literature prior to the arrival of Robert C. Merton did a great job of explaining the time dimension of resource allocation. Terrible job of dealing with uncertainty. And really what makes finance a separate branch of economics, some would say, it's more than just economics, but the science of finance is all about the element of risk. Yes, timing is very important as well, but it's really risk and how you model that correctly. So it starts with a pair of papers written as part of Bob Merton's doctoral dissertation, along with his thesis advisor, Paul Samuelson, back in 1969. Both of the papers, which were published in the same journal the same year, are about life cycle consumption and investment decisions, portfolio choice decisions. The element that Bob Merton brought to bear was a whole branch of mathematics which had never been used before in economics. It's called the Itô calculus, stochastic calculus, in continuous time. He revolutionized the field.
Well, you guys have been working on this for 50 years now, and let's get into the slides. Here's your clickers.
Thank you.